by way of, okay? Beginning with Aries now. So we'll look at past, present, and future. And then we will look at what to let go of, what to embrace, and a best path forward. So 6 cards per sign, and I think if we do 6 signs on a deck, that's good enough, and then we can turn into the other deck. Okay. Alrighty, Aries, let's see what we have here. Past, and we have, come on, cooperate. And we have the 7 of Cups. Present, and we have La Papesa, shall we say, the High Priestess. And future-wise, okay, we have the Devil. Alrighty. Past, you have been through situations where you were able to overcome obstacles. You're able to gain wisdom from your past experience, okay? To a point where presently now you apply this life skills and knowledge that you have gained from past experiences that give you confidence with the High Priestess. Now, the mode of the present operation is really listen more, analyze more, assess situations more, and then give your information or give your approval, Aries, if you will. So this is general as it can be, but really speaking to a solid stance on situations around different areas of life, okay? And more also about the way that you may handle relationships. Now, relationships, be it with love relationships, you know what, business relationships, family relationships, etc., etc. You are becoming more of, shall we say, a listener here. Future-wise, Aries, you have a way to break free from things that hold you back. And here comes the Devil card. So, things within your control, elements that you could change on a daily basis to improve your life, to improve different situations. You now have this knowledge. You have this wisdom from your past experiences with this 7 of Cups. So, moving forward, the task is nothing but willpower. That's what I say when I see the Devil. Alrighty. This came out, guys. Now let's see about what to let go of, what to embrace, and a note on a best path forward. What to let go of? We have here the Knight of Wands. Well, we don't let go of the Knight of Wands. We let go of the action without planning, okay? We don't want to let go of the energy. We don't want to let go of the motivation. But really, the message would be putting those, channeling those kinds of positive energies, upward mobility, your achievement, your success, your needs, your wants, okay, with information. And also, after careful study, okay, you use your life experiences here. You act like the High Priestess in using your intuition, but also using some facts as well. Now, what to embrace more of? And here it is. There's the answer, the Knight of Swords. A little bit more facts, a little bit more information. I'm not talking about business or anything, but a little bit more, less heart, if you will, knowledge, mind, and a little bit less of the passion that a lot of times, you know what, goes very, very well to your advantage, but may not be always understood. Okay, best path forward, and we have here the Queen of Cups. It ties in a way to the present, if the note resonated with you, ties in a way with La Papisa, the High Priestess. More of a listener, okay? So that's something we want to embrace with a grain of salt, okay? Less haphazard action, if that even resonates. More analysis, and taking it a little slow, that's all. That's the message. Now, does that relate to, you know what, life in general? No. This is a general message regarding the next phase from one new moon to another new moon. And hopefully some of it will resonate, Aries. Alrighty. So, this is Aries. Now, let's go put them here, actually. Okay, now